Hello everyone, I hope you're all doing fine and you're happy and healthy.
Yeah, in today's video we actually sit down because we're gonna talk about our budget and travel costs, because ever since we started traveling and even before we left, this is the topic that we're getting the most questions about. So people always ask us, like, how much we are spending, how much does it cost to travel Central America, and how we're doing with our money, and if we still have money left to keep traveling. But before we talk about our budget and how we're doing right now, we have to go back a little bit to how it all started. So back in 2020, during lockdown, we actually said that what we want the most is to travel full time and go on a big world trip. But back then we kind of had maybe almost 5,000 euros together, because during COVID we both kind of lost our jobs and we were living off our savings. So yeah, we really didn't have the money to just travel full time, and we were thinking, okay, how can we make it work? What can we do to get money fast so we can leave fast?
Yes.
So we made a plan, and we actually gave ourselves 3 months to make 15,000 euro was what we said then. And we were in Greece at the time, and we kind of said, okay, where is the best for us to make money? Yeah, that's probably in Amsterdam. There are more chances there. So we went back to Amsterdam, and while in lockdown, the stores were closed, restaurants were closed. So we literally did everything from a pop-up shop in our house to running a Michelin star restaurant from our living room. George even did
personal training.
Yeah, he just became a personal trainer just like that. So we were really hustling and literally selling every spoon, every cup we had, just to get the money.
And yes, we reached our goal. We saved up to 17,000 euro. If you remember, our goal was 15,000 euro, but we did too good. And we saved up 2,000 euro extra for the difficult times. We just took our backpacks, our camera and our laptops, and we traveled all the way to Mexico.
Yeah, so that's actually where it started. 17,000 euro on our bank accounts, no stuff left, no house, nothing to keep us attached, and the whole world to explore. And actually I've been traveling for about 10 years before we left, so I have quite some experience when it comes to budget traveling and backpacking. So I made, just before we left, I made a calculation of what we should spend a day to be able to travel for at least a year, but preferably 1.5 years. And then we set a budget of 33 euros. So that was gonna be our daily budget. And yeah, this is quite a low budget, but we knew that there would be days that we would spend less and there would be days that we would be spending more. But if we would keep this budget in mind, we would be able to be gone for almost 1.5 years.
Exactly. Now, the difficult part was how to track of all this money. How are we actually gonna keep in track what we're spending, how much money we have left, and all that, just every day, because every single thing that you are spending, from a water up until a coffee or food or accommodation, transportation, everything has to be calculated. And yeah, then we did a research. Actually, Lotus did a very good research, and we found an app, an application, which it called Travel Spend. And
yeah, I mean, there are hundreds of travel apps out there, but we found that this one was the best one for us. And yeah, we set from day one to upload everything, and that's what we did. Like, literally every cup of coffee, every taxi ride, everything. And this is really great because, for instance, when we were in Mexico, we were tracking what we were spending, and then we were going out for dinner all the time because we were so excited about the street food. And then in the app we would see that our cost of restaurant was so much higher than everything else, and we started realizing, like, okay, that's definitely where we can cut the cost so we can do other cool stuff. So maybe it's good to show you the app so you see how it works.
This is the app here. You can see that on top, on the left, there is a total amount of money. It's our budget actually, and Here you can see 9,129 euro is the money that we have spent already.
Yeah, since we left on March 17, and this includes really everything. So flights, COVID tests, accommodation, transportation, food, everything.
Everything, yeah. And under this amount of money, you can see the amount of money that is still left in our budget, but the budget that we have put here in this app is 15,000 euro, and we said that we had saved up 17,000 euro.
Yeah, we have that 2,000 euro actually as a like a safety backup, so whatever happens, we have 2,000 euro to get us home or to get us out of a situation, or yeah, whatever that you have, or if it's really like a device of our crashes, like our laptop or cameras, yeah, that
anything,
we have
yeah,
a backup that has nothing to do with our daily budget.
Exactly. That's basically the app. Here you can see, actually, we said that we have 15,000 euro to spend from 17 March of 2021 up until 30 of May 2022. So So with that being said, yes, I think you did it. This.
I forgot for how long I calculated the budget, but it's like a year and
three months. 3 months. So with that being said, we still have to spend until May 6,000 euro from our 15,000 budget without the 2,000 extra. And let me show you here a little bit about what we are paying attention. Every now and then we're checking our daily budget. 33 euro is our daily budget. This is that the money, the amount we have to spend maximum if we want to keep traveling for 1 year and 3 months. So you can see here that our daily average spend is 35 euro, so we are up 2 euro daily. And yeah, this happens sometimes.
Yeah, but it's really nice because you also see that we are 203 euro now above our budget, so we really know really clear what we have to do to save that money again.
So what we have to do?
Save 203 euro and not buy so many candies anymore.
Exactly, so this is exactly what we are doing. We are checking our costs, and you can see, for example, that flights are the most money that we spent.
Yeah, so maybe let's go through them. From this 9,129 euro that we've been spending so far, we've been spending 2,384.50 euros on flights alone, which is a lot.
We're spending 1,848.94 euro in accommodations, like hotels, Airbnbs, booking, everything.
Yeah, then we've spent 1,376 euros on restaurants, so that's really like eating out.
From street food, restaurants, everything.
Breakfast,
basically.
Lunch, dinner, anything we
exactly
we set in a place.
Exactly. Then we have groceries. Actually, this is the money that we spent by buying food and groceries for our house. So then we are cooking at home and we're saving up a lot of money.
Yeah, so that's also when we're, for instance, staying in hostels or we have an Airbnb, we always get groceries straight away and then we live off that for a few days.
So then we have transportation. We spend 921 euro in transportation, buses, colectivos,
chicken buses
and basically taxis, everything else we tuk-tuks and
we rented a scooter at some point, that's also in there.
Yeah, and then we have other costs. That those other costs, they were 1,334 euro. So basically this is all our categories of how we're spending our money. As you can imagine, we have no more subscriptions. We don't own subscription on Netflix or phones or like all these subscriptions that back in the day when we were like, before we start traveling, we had numerous of them and we had to pay them every month.
Yeah, thank you so much for my sister-in-law that we can still use her Netflix account.
Yes.
No, but Yeah, so basically this is what we've been spending in the last 8 months. We're on the road now, right?
9 months.
Nine months.
Yes.
So we have been spending, for the two of us, just a little bit over €1,000 a month for us together, which is really, really good if you think about it. That's like really traveling on a budget. And then we thought we want to share a little bit with you how we managed to do that, because I think that also a lot of travelers are spending a lot more than us. And we have a few tips and tricks of how we have been saving money along the way.
Every day we make sure that we can have a nice deal in accommodation, so we pay. We found our tricks there, like not really
booking directly through Airbnb, sending the people a message or finding locals.
Exactly. And then also, like, for food, we said that we, in the beginning, we start spending a lot of money in street food and eating outside in restaurants, and by buying groceries and cooking at home, we save up a lot of money.
Yeah, but I think what's most important to say is that our priority has been from day one to travel as long as possible. Like, we didn't leave everything behind to just travel a few months and do only amazing stuff and go back home. Our goal was always to make this last as long as possible. So if once you have that in your mind, you start really being conscious about your money, because if you can do that one amazing volcano trek or something, but if you spend it on that, it also, you can travel 3-4 full days longer with accommodation and food. So you really, every time we put everything on the, what's the English word? On the scale, yeah, exactly. And we always knew, and that's, I think we're very lucky that we both have that, we always knew what was the more long-term goal. So you can, we could make decisions in the now to not go out for food all the time or have drinks the whole night long in a bar or cocktails, but to buy a beer in the local supermarket and just sit on the beach ourselves, for instance. There are so many things you can do to still have a nice experience but save a lot of money.
Or if we want to go out for dinner, we won't go to the most popular restaurant in the area, but we're going where locals go to eat, or some nice street food. And in general, we start really appreciating more nature, because we do so many things that actually it's out there, and nature is out there. It's free from everyone. You don't need to pay. You just wake up in the morning. Sunrises are for free. Sunsets are for free. To enjoy the beach and the shadow and, I don't know, a peaceful morning is for free, go run outside. So all these activities that actually and basically people skip because there are more nice activities
to buy
or entertaining things by paying money. Now we start really appreciating these moments. And
And I think it also, because we are like this, it also made us travel a little bit more like we were just living in a place. Like, we would feel really like locals, because we were not doing all the touristy things, the tourist traps. We just tried to find a nice cheap house in a neighborhood, or and do our groceries at the local market. So we were kind of really adapting as well in the life at a place. So for instance, in Guatemala, like, every single day again, we would go in Lake Atitlan to the same market because we knew that that lady had the cheapest tomatoes or something. Yeah. So that's what you would maybe also do if you would live there, instead of just hopping from the one tour to the other. We really indulged in the culture as well.
Yeah,
so you really just become more conscious about everything. And I think that that's a great way to be able to travel cheaper and therefore also longer. Okay, we just realized that we are already talking for a very long time, so we can't go like too detailed in what we exactly spend it in what country and how much. Maybe we can do another video on that anytime soon. But yeah, we also want to say, because actually we have spent it now about €9,000, so that means that we have €6,000 left and our €2,000 backup money that we don't want to touch. So we are starting to feel that, oh my god, we're
running out.
We passed the
half of our budget.
Exactly. And we really don't want to stop traveling. So We said from the beginning that we would do everything to keep traveling, from house sitting to, I don't know, staying on a farm and volunteer, or
couch
all these
surfing or yeah, whatever is couch, needed.
Like, exactly, whatever is needed to be done to keep the costs low. And yeah, we would still do that, but now we feel very much that we want to maintain this traveling, and we actually want to start really making money while traveling.
So what are we going to do?
Well, that we will be sharing with you really, really soon, like actually already in the upcoming videos. We're gonna involve that more in how we manage to travel full time, but at the same time make money, and how we're gonna do that.
How we're gonna try to make money.
Yeah, because maybe we're not gonna succeed at all, and we still need to just volunteer on a farm.
But that's gonna be fun, let's see.
That's gonna be the adventure, yeah. This yeah. About our budget so far. Let us also know in the comments if you have more questions about this. We're happy to answer them there. We really like to have the conversation over there, so don't hesitate.
Yeah, and share your thoughts about what do you think about us? Like, where to come? Like, do you think that we just have money running out of our pockets, or I don't know, what was your idea before you watch this video? Yeah, so if you're still watching this video, yeah, thank you so much. We really appreciate, and we will see you in the next and upcoming videos.
Yes, bye bye.